إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله Indeed the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ And every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدُ My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Shaykh Abdul Aziz bin Ibaz, rahimahullah, he said, مَنْ حَفَظَ وَقْتَهُ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَقْرَاءَةُ الْقُرْآنِ وَصُحْبَةِ الْإِخْيَارِ وَالْبُعْدِ عَنْ صُحْبَةِ الْغَافِلِينَ وَالْأَشْرَارِ يُطِيبُ قَلْبَهُ وَيَلِينَ Shaykh Abdul Aziz bin Ibaz, rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy on him. May Allah have mercy on this Shaykh for his prudence and his prioritization of the Quran and the Sunnah and the affairs of all the Muslims across the world and the Ummah, regardless of where they're from. His concern for the Ummah and especially for the youth. And he gave the best of advice and the best of guidance as he did with this statement, so let us analyze it. He said, Rahimahullah, whoever preserves his time with the remembrance of Allah, with the recitation of the Quran, with accompanying good people and maintaining a distance from the heedless ones and the evildoers, then his heart will become good and soft. So let us analyze this advice from the noble Shaykh, Rahimahullah. مَنْ حَفَظَ وَقْتَهُ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ Whoever preserves his time with the remembrance of Allah, then his heart will become good and soft. We must remind ourselves of the value of time. Allah swore by it, and He only swears by things that have a lot of weight, that are grand. Money can go, but it can come back. Land can go, but it can come back. Even loved ones you have, you'll get other ones that you love around you. But time, once it passes, it's gone. And this is why it's so grand and valuable that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He stated, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ He swore by time, saying by time, by the ages, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ Indeed, mankind is in a state of loss, following their desires, following their whims, living the life of this dunya as if it's the only life to live. إِلَّا Except, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ Except for those who believe and do righteous deeds. Another proof that Iman is not just a belief in the heart. Iman is not just the statement of the tongue saying the Shahada, but that it also includes العمل بالجوارح, the actions of the limbs doing the righteous deeds. Except for those who believe and do righteous deeds, and they enjoin and encourage one another to the truth. And they enjoin and encourage one another with patience. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصُوا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصُوا بِالصَّبْرِ Patience during those trials. So this time is important. He said, preserve your time with the remembrance of Allah. Allah says, الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. Allah said in the Quran, what means those who believe in the oneness of Allah and whose hearts find rest in the remembrance of Allah. Indeed, Allah said with firmness, indeed in the remembrance of Allah will the hearts find rest. So stop seeking that comfort of the heart, the consolement of the heart and your feelings and what you're going through from other than Allah. He made it easy. Remember Him and He will be there to comfort you. It's not going to be found in the music, in the drugs, in the affairs of following one's desires. It will be found with the remembrance of Allah. قال الله فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. Allah says what means, therefore remember me. Remember me by praying to me, by glorifying me, by praising me, by extolling me. And I will remember you and be grateful to me for the countless favors. وَإِنْ تُعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْسُوهَا. Even if you were to try and enumerate all of the blessings of Allah, you wouldn't come close. Remember the favors of Allah upon you and never be ungrateful to me. Never be ungrateful to me. But you want Allah to be there for you, to support you, to guide you, to grant you relief during your hardship. Then you must remember Him. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ وَاذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ فِي نَفْسِكَ تَضُرُّعًا وَخِيفَةً وَدُونَ الْجَهْرِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ بِالْغَدُوِّ وَالْأَصَالِ وَلَا تُكُمْ مِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ. Allah says what means, and remember your Lord by your tongue and within yourself, humbly and without fear, humbly and with fear, and without loudness in words in the mornings and the afternoons, and be not of those who are neglectful. So Allah tied the one who remembers Him, who does not remember Him, to be one who is neglectful. Neglectful of his deen. Neglectful of his next life, of his akhirah. Neglectful of his Lord. Why? Because he did not remember his Lord. So those two go hand in hand. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سبق المفردون قالوا وما المفردون يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الذاكرون الله كثيرا والذاكرات رواه مسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in Sahih Muslim, he said, the مفردون have gone ahead. They've advanced, they've surpassed, they've elevated themselves to a status above the others. The companion said, who are the مفردون يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم? Who are they? He said, those men and women who remember Allah frequently and celebrate the remembrances of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To go ahead, to get higher. We know the hadith of the bounties, of the rewards for saying Alhamdulillah and Subhanallah and Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. And all of these things, Subhanallah al-Azim. We know these things. Remember Allah, such light phrases. Remember those two phrases. Subhanallah al-Azim, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Khafifatan ala al-lisan, habibatan ila al-Rahman, faqilatan ala al-mizan. They're light on the tongue, heavy on the scales, most beloved to al-Rahman, to the most merciful. Abdullah ibn Musa radiallahu anhu, he reported that one of the companions said, إِنَّ شِرَاعِ الْإِسْلَامِ قَدْ كَثُرَتْ عَلَيَّ. He said, the injunctions of Islam have been made too many upon me. It's too much for me to handle all at once. And this deen is a deen of yusr. It's a deen of moderation. It's a deen where we were instructed to do as much as we can without burning yourself out or neglecting those who have rights over you or things that have rights over you. So he said this, so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or Afwan, so he told him, tell me something that I can do that will be good for me, that's simple. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لا يزال لسانك رطبا من ذكر الله. Let your tongue be moist with the remembrance of Allah. Always remember Allah. So many occasions we say, I don't have time, I don't have time, I don't have time. Or we say we're so tired, or we'll get mesmerized by things that have no avail to us, no benefit to us, than just saying words like Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, and saying the likes of these phrases. Keep your tongue wet with the remembrance of Allah. If you feel like there's so much that you can't do, at least do this. Keep your tongue remembering your Lord. وعن أبي موسى رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مثل الذي يذكر ربه والذي لا يذكر ربه مثل الحي والميت. The Prophet ﷺ, he said in authentic hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, that the example of the one who remembers his Lord and the one who doesn't remember his Lord is like the living and the dead. The one who doesn't remember Allah, he might be breathing, walking, talking, running, exerting, it doesn't matter. This is as good as a dead soul. A dead person, the one who does not remember his Lord. وعن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما, he said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, لا تكثروا لا تكثروا الكلام بغير ذكر الله فإن كثرة الكلام بغير ذكر الله قسوة للقلب وإن أبعد الناس من الله من الله القلب القاسي. رواه الترمذي وهذا حديث حسن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, do not talk too much without the remembrance of Allah. We're warned of this, even the gatherings that we all do with family and friends, hours sitting there, shooting the breeze, kicking it, and there's no mention of Allah. Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, do not talk too much with anyone or anything without the remembrance of Allah. Indeed, excessive talking without the remembrance of Allah, it deadens or hardens the heart. And indeed, the farthest people from Allah is the one who has a harsh heart, or a heart far from Allah, a hard heart. The hardened heart is the one furthest from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, if you could hear the sounds of the angels, pens, writing your names down, as being from the ones who remember Allah, then you would die out of joy. The angels, everything, the malaika, everything you say, every insha'Allah, every subhanallah, every alhamdulillah, every la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, and so on, they're marking it down for you. And if you could hear the angels writing it, you would die out of joy for them witnessing you. So it could be a witness for you on the Day of Judgment. These malaika, the scribes, the witnesses, look at the honor they can give you. So for the heart to be good and soft, the Shaykh Ibn Baz, rahimahullah, he said, you have to remember Allah. And then he mentioned, من حفظ وقته بقراءة القرآن. Also the one who preserves his time with the recitation of the Qur'an, then his heart will become good and soft. Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِدَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah says, what means, O mankind, there has come to you a good advice. The words of Allah, directly from your Lord above the seven heavens, above his arsh, separate from his creation, sending him down with angel Jibreel to Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. This Qur'an, commanding the good and forbidding the evil, a healing for that you have. All of the diseases of ignorance, of jahil, of the jahiliyyah, of shak, of doubt, of nifaq, of hypocrisy, the differences that go between the people, this is the cure. It is in the Qur'an. And in your hearts, a guidance and a mercy, explaining the halal and the haram for the believers. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يُزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. And Allah says, what means, and we send down from the Qur'an that which is a healing and a mercy to those who believe. Those who believe in the oneness of Allah, in the tawheed that Allah sent to this world, to this ummah, to this world, and who act upon it, and it increases the zalimun, the polytheists and the wrongdoers, in nothing but loss. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, many times we forget this. Ramadan is 4 months away. Ramadan has become the month of the Quran, and every other month, it's almost as if the Quran isn't in our face, at our hands, at our exposure. At every second we want it to be there. And this is a crime we commit against our own selves. Ramadan, 4 months away. The Sahaba had the effects of Ramadan for 6 months. The next five, they were preparing for Ramadan. So take this advice from the Shaykh and start implementing the recitation of the Qur'an, and let us not wait until Ramadan. Anas ibn Malik, radiallahu anhu, he said that the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ أَهْلِينَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. He said that the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said that Allah has special people from mankind, His special ones. All of us have a special group of friends. All of us have something or someone that's special to them. And they keep this in mind. He said, Allah has a group of special people. قَالُوا مَنْ هُمْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ or يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَنْ هُمْ or Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, who are those people? Because the Sahaba were eager to be the best. They wanted to be elevated in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, هُمْ أَهْلَ الْقُرْآنِ أَهْلَ اللَّهِ وَخَاصَتَهُ. He said, they are the people of Quran. The people of Allah, the special people to Allah, and His, those who are closest to Him, His beloved ones. So you can achieve that rank, but you can't if the Qur'an is put to the side. You can't if the Qur'an is just mentioned once a year, in 1 month out of the year. You can't if the Qur'an is not part of your daily life. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قرأ عشر آيات في ليلة لم يكتب من الغافلين. This hadith with the sahih لغيره is authentic due to external evidences. According to Sheikh Al-Albani rahimahullah, he said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever reads 10 verses, 10 آيات in the night, they will never be recorded amongst the ghafilin, amongst those who are negligent, those who are heedless. To read 10 ayat a night, it can be in your bed. It can be right by your bed. You can read it before you sleep. Just reading 10 ayat before you sleep, you'll never be recorded amongst those who are negligent towards Allah, towards the Quran, towards your deen. وعن إكرمة عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال ضمن الله لمن اتبع القرآن أن لا يضل في الدنيا ولا يشقى في الآخرة ثم تلا فمن اتبع هدايا فلا يضل ولا يشقى. And Ikrama he mentioned that Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said, Allah has guaranteed for the one who follows the Quran that he will not be led astray in the world and he will not be cursed or damned in the hereafter. Then he recited the ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thus whoever follows my guidance will not be led astray, nor cursed or damned. This is in the Musannaf of Ibn Abi Shayba. To read the Quran to protect you in this life and in the Akhirah. وعن سفيان رضي الله عنه قال قال عثمان رضي الله عنه لو أن قلوبنا طهرت ما شبعت من كلام الله. And Sufyan, he said, that Uthman radiallahu anhu, he said, if our hearts were pure, we would never be tired from the speech of Allah. We would never be tired from it. But the Quran daily gets the backlog. I'm too busy, I don't have time, but we spend hours on our phone, searching, looking at things that bring us no benefit. If our hearts were pure, we would never get tired from the Quran. We would never get tired from the words of Allah and the speech of Allah. Because it was meant to guide us towards a Jannah forever and ever, if our hearts were pure. So let us reflect upon these two, inshallah. May Allah make us from those who remember him and recite his book and keep good company. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم أدعو الله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Sheikh Ibn Baz, rahimahullah, he gave us a beautiful reminder, beautiful advice of how to preserve our time. Dhikrillah, to remember Allah at all times so that you are from those who truly are living. Your heart is living because you are in the remembrance of Allah. Truly, that's when your heart will find rest. With the recitation of the Quran, so you can be the special people to Allah, the special group whom Allah loves, and the angels write down every word, every ayah, every letter you say, and Allah rewards you by it tenfold. And we get to the last part of his nasiha, of his advice. وَمَنْ حَفِظَ وَقْتَهُ بِصُحْبَةِ الْأَخْيَارِ وَبِالْبُعْدِ عَنْ صُحْبَةِ الْغَافِلِينَ وَالْأَشْرَارِ. The Shaykh, he then mentioned, and whoever preserves his time with accompanying good people, with accompanying good people, and maintaining a distance from the heedless ones and the evildoers, his heart will become good and soft. His heart will become good and soft. Know who your companions are. Know who your friends are. Even if they're your family and they're your blood, they may be from the heedless ones, the evil ones, whom you want to be cautious about and not accompany with unless it's safe for you. Yes, we don't encourage cutting off the family ties, but you have to protect yourself. We saw this last week when we briefly mentioned the hadith of the man who killed 99 and then he killed 100. When he went to the alam, finally, when he went to the scholar told him, go to this land, in it you will find people, people of tawheed who worship Allah, good people. Spend your time with them and this and that. That's part of that tawbah. That's part of يعني, you going to repent to Allah. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الرجل على دين خليله فلينظر أحدكم من يخالب. رواه أبي داود وهذا حديث حسن. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, a man follows the religion of his friend. Don't say, no, I won't. Because we've seen it happen to the best of us. Don't say, I know what I'm doing. Because this is the common thing, and then guess what? You find it slowly and slowly. You may not end up following what they're following, but they'll pull you away from what you should be doing and what you should be following. Our Prophet ﷺ said, a man follows the religion of his friend, so each one of you should consider whom he makes his friend. Consider who you befriend. This doesn't mean you be rude. It doesn't mean you show bad character. It doesn't mean you show bad manners and bad morals. Wal'ayadu billah. We were commanded to be the best in the world of morals, of character, of manners, to the Muslim, to the non-Muslim. Even when we slaughter, we're supposed to be good and merciful and kind when we slaughter our animals. And then how about to the other human beings? Allah said, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ وَلَا تَعْدُ أَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبُهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ وَكَانَ أَمْرُهُ فُرَطًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says what means. And keep yourself, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, patiently with those who call upon their Lord, your companions. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him to befriend and keep close to those who remember Allah and call upon Allah and make dua to Allah with glorification, with praise, with doing their prayers, with their righteous deeds, morning and afternoon, seeking His face. And let not your eyes overlook them. Do not overlook those who your deen is safe with, because you desire the pomp and the desires of this dunya, because you desire the pomp and the glitter of the life of this world. This is Allah instructing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Keep to your companions, even though you might be weaker or less in number, weaker in strength, and the likes of these matters. Just because you desire, yani do not look at those who desire the pomp and the glitter of this life, and obey not him whose heart we have made heedless of our remembrance. Do not accompany those who are heedless. They do not care about remembering Allah, one who follows his own lusts and whose affairs and deeds have been lost. A command from Allah to our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that command stands even more in regards to us. وعن أبي الأحوص عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه. He said, قال أكثروا ذكر الله عز وجل ولا عليك أن لا تصحب أحدا إلا من أعانك على ذكر الله عز وجل. In شعب الإيمان, أبو الأحوص, he reported that عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه, he said, remember Allah the Almighty often. Always remember Allah, and you must not accompany anyone unless they help you remember Allah the Almighty. Do not accompany anyone unless he's the one who will remind you. Hey man, you're eating with your left hand, eat with your right. Hey man, put your right shoe on first before your left shoe. Hey akhi, you forgot to say salamu alaykum when you entered the masjid. Hey akhi, you forgot to dua when entering the masjid. The reminders, the one who helps you remember Allah when you sneeze and you're heedless and you forget to say Alhamdulillah, that he'll remind you, Ya Akhi, say Alhamdulillah, don't forget. So we can say Irhamakallah to you, we can ask Allah to have mercy upon you. This is the friends and the companions you should have. Ya Akhi, it's Salah time. Let's leave this video game for a second, or this game we're watching, or this thing that we're doing, and let's go make our prayers and we can get back to this. This is the companions you should have, the ones who remember Allah. If they don't tell you any of these things, be mindful of what true friend they really are. Because nowadays the true friend is the one who keeps your secret, or the one who won't tell on you. And this is baloney. The true friend is the one who's going to help you remember Allah and always stay steadfast to Allah. عن أبي موسى رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما مثل الجليس الصالح والجليس السوء كحامل المسك ونافخ الكير فحامل المسك إن إما أن يحذيك وإما أن تبتاع منه وإما أن تجد منه ريحا طيبة ونافخ الكير إما أن يحرق ثيابك أو إما أن تجد ريحا خبيثة. This hadith which we find in Bukhari and Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he compared, he gave us a parable of the good company, the good companion, the good friend and the bad companion, or the bad company to be around. And he said it's only like the seller of musk and the blacksmith. The blacksmith is the one who works in a dark place where he's burning metal and an iron, and the fumes from it are very aggressive. So he said the seller of musk, the one who sells perfumes and colognes and something that smells good, he will give you some of it. You'll benefit, he'll give you something good for you to benefit from. Or he will buy you some. He will aid you towards doing something good. Or at least you'll get a good smell from him. At least you will leave with your deen preserved. This is like the good companion. But the one who's the blacksmith, the one who's working in the bellows, heating that iron and that all that stuff, all that that nature of aggressive fumes and things which are abhorrent, this person is like the bad company, the bad friend. When you're around them even, they'll burn your clothes. And even if they don't, at the very least, you'll acquire such an abhorrent smell, a bad smell. This is like the one who is the bad friend and the bad companion. This is why Allah showed us the end result of those who had wrong and bad companions, and what they will say on the Day of Judgment. وَيَوْمَ يَعُدُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَىٰ يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي أَتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. The one where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what means, and remember the day when the zalim, the one who was the wrongdoer and the oppressor, the polytheist, he will bite at his hands and he will say, oh, would that I had taken the path of the messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will regret, but his regret won't do him any good because he cannot come back to this world. He cannot go back and undo what he did. He said, would that I had just followed his sunnah. Would that I had just done what he had commanded me to do. Ya waylata laytani lam attakhadha fulana khalila. And woe to me, how much I deserve to be humiliated. Would that I had never had taken such and such as a friend. I wish I never took this person as a friend or as a companion. Why? لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنَ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. Because indeed this friend, he led me astray. From what? From the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the reminder, from the Quran, from my prayers, from remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and glorifying Him and praising Him. After it had come to me, and shaitan, Satan, is ever a deserter to man in an hour of need. Shaitan, the one who you blame for it, when you try to blame him, he's going to flee and say, I didn't tell you to do nothing. You did this on your own. But what? That friend will cause you to bite and regret because he took you away, he distracted you from the reminder of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the Quran, from the remembrance of Allah, and from all that was good and commanded, and he led you towards what was forbidden and evil. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, these three things, this will cause the heart to become good and soft, and it is the heart that matters in the end, what we will be judged by. As Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he said to the mushrikeen, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مِنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. He told the mushrikeen, on that day of resurrection, leave off the evil you're upon, or else on that day, your wealth, your family, your children, your sons, they will not avail you, they'll be of no help to you, except for him who brings to Allah a clean and pure heart, free from shirk, free from nifaq, from hypocrisy, free from all that evil, because his heart was clean and pure. And we know the hadith of Nu'man ibn Bashir, where the Prophet ﷺ, he said, إِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةٍ. In every body is a piece of flesh. إِذَا صَلَحَتْ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ. If it is sound, if it's good, if it's pious, if it's clean, if it repents to Allah when it sins, then the rest of the body will be good. وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ. But if it is corrupt, if it is evil, if it has no care for the reminder of Allah, for the remembrance of Allah, for the recitation of the Quran, for who its companions are, then the rest of it is going to be corrupt. The rest of it will be evil. In summary, the statement of Shaykh ibn Baz, rahimahullah, من حفظ وقته بذكر الله وقراءة القرآن وصحبة الأخيار والبعد عن صحبة الغافلين والأشرار يطيب قلبه وينين. His statement, whoever preserves his time with the remembrance of Allah and the recitation of the Quran, and keeping good company of people, and maintaining a distance from those who are heedless and evildoers, then his heart will become good and soft. Preserve your time with these things. Be careful of all those distractions. It's like stronger than a magnet trying to pull you in every direction. But time is something you can't get back. So preserve it with these things, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. For yourselves, for your families, for anfusikum wa ahlikum nara. Save yourselves and your families from the hellfire, whose fuel is stones and men. Allahumma khalli al-muslimin wal-muslimat, al-mu'minin wal-mu'minat. الأحياء منهم الأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.